Well, so I'm Anna Lochard from La 27e Région, French lab of public innovation, as you have guessed from my lovely accent, right? So a lot of really interesting things have been said already. I will try to not be too repetitive as we begin to come close from the midday. And I will maybe just give you some insight about the history of our lab. So we are DoTank. We define ourselves as a DoTank. I think we already discussed about the importance to be in the action as well as in the reflection. And the 27th region was born in 2008 when Stéphane Vincent, who used to work in consulting company for public administration and as Adam Price will say, still in the recovery, met Romain Thévenet, who was a young designer, just get out from the Annecy Les Ateliers School, a really famous design school in France. Maybe a small historical context. At the beginning of the 21st century in France, there was a lot of transformation within public administration with a movement called New Public Management. I don't know if a lot of you are familiar with this name, but it's a really liberal movement based on responsibility, cost management, indicators, and also a lot of, well, it's really complex, but it was implemented in France with Nicolas Sarkozy in 2004. And in 2008, there were a lot of criticism about this way of thinking things and doing things. And some initiatives such as the Mind Lab or the Nesta were already up. And I think Stéphane Vincent and Romain Thévenet at the beginning where they were creating the La 27e Région were trying to make something different from the new public management because there were no actually alternative. So the 27th region is like this new imaginary territory that does not exist yet and where we can begin to imagine different things. And at the beginning, we were incubated into another organization, and after 4 years, we took our independence and become a non-profit, independent non-profit, but our members are part of institutions. So now we have around 20 members, and that's how we managed to do the in and out posture that we already discussed. We are independent, but we have on our board institutions themselves. I will also add that we are a really small team of 9 persons, but we are working with a full ecosystem of practitioners, designers, also urban planners or researchers, and that's how we manage to have a really pluridisciplinarity within our project. Before to develop more our three main programs, I would like to go back on the values that were already discussed by the previous speakers. I will say that the values of the 27th region can be described as the three core values. The first one will be to go from the users and to try to make with the users, but we have a really inclusive way of seeing the users. It's not like the civil servants on one side and the users on the other side. We think that the civil servants and the representative elected are also users in our way. So the idea is more to think a new way to approach expertise and the expert position more than to say, look, this is one user, what he is doing, and what can we do with him? We are all users, what can we do with that? So that's one thing. The second core value will be more about action and more collective action and the right to fail. It was already discussed earlier. Actions, because when you have a lot of creativity, a lot of idea, but what you do after, how do you implement in concrete public policies, that's what is difficult, right? So you have to try, and sometimes you fail, but you have to think that it's a collective failure if it's a failure, and if you have a success, it's a collective success. So that's another important thing to keep in mind. And maybe a last value is about open source and documentation. It was not discussed already, I think, but how can we think that in the open source movement, there are a lot of things that could be really interesting for administrations, because we think that often administrations feel in competition one with each other, and feel also that they own their concept, they have to protect it. And maybe the open source movement give a way to think in a more collaborative and inclusive way. And also, we know it's difficult to document our process, but I think it's a kind of something we have to stick with, so we can inspire other people and give them some insights on how to make change if they want to make change. And well, so. I will say that the three core values, but also I would like just to say thank you to the three previous persons who were speaking about values, because of course it's not a question of left or right party, but maybe it's more a question about are we helping like the ideology that we are trying to fight to adapt, or are we trying to develop an alternative, a new alternative? And I guess there is no clear answer to that, of course, but the easiest way to try to make a good job and to stick to your values is to ask the question every day to yourself and to your team, and that's how you try to be the more honest and the more correct to your values as possible. But that's definitely a tricky question. So our first program that we begin to implement in 2009 is called Territoire en Résidence, Territories in Residences. Actually, the map is not accurate, because now we are at 15 experimentation. It's a three months long program with 3 weeks of immersion within a public administration object, such as a high school, a train station, or in the example I choose to take, a public library. And we try to solve a challenge within this institution. So for example, in Le Zoo, which is in the center of France, we try to imagine what could be the new public library that the city of Le Zoo wanted to build. And we use all those methodologies that we already spoke. But maybe about ethnography, I will develop just a little bit more. What is difficult with ethnography is, like, can you imagine how long it takes to have the authorization to take the civil servants actually on the ground? It's like you have to really fight within administration for like more than 1 month. So that's also why our project can be a little bit long. It's also like an intern fight. And it's not just easy to take people from the administration and make them go abroad. It's like really difficult. So ethnography, why is it important? In this case, we discovered that since there were no public library, there were a lot of civil movements that were already existing to exchange books, to make readings and stuff. So the idea was really to try to find them and help the new library to be a tool for them, and not a new, and not a way to destroy what already was happening on the field. I think I have to go a little bit quickly. But our second program was born in 2011, and the name is La Transfo. It's a longer program. It's a 10 weeks of immersion through 2 years of experimentation. So 2 years, it's a really long time, I guess, for us. And the aim of the program is to test, prototype, and then make sustainable a public innovation lab within an administration. So it's really to create a lab. So it's big. We made it in 4 regions: Champagne-Ardenne, Pays de la Loire, Provence-Alpes-Côte d'Azur, and Bourgogne. And actually, it was a success in three of those four regions. We could speak later why it failed in one region. But there are actually three labs in those regions that are still working 2 years after the program. And there are regional elections soon in France, and we hope that those labs will made it just like the main lab made it when there was an alternance. But so far, so good. And I have to say, it really helps the community of public innovators in France to develop. And this program was so successful that we want to launch it, a new one, next year. And finally, our more recent program is a public reactor, Reactor Public, bringing together not only regional government, but also state and local government. Because in France, we really have a difficulty to discuss on different level of government. It's really, it's something that they are not used to work together. So the idea of public reactor was to build on that and try to go further with all of those actors on four axes. The first one is skills, because when things that we realize is like when you begin to be a civil servant, you never heard of innovation, you don't have any skill about that, and you have to discover yourself how you could do things differently. So how do we put those skills within the trainings and at a soon stage? And it's really difficult because for that we have to work with national training centers, which are also administration themselves and have their own complexity. So that, yeah, that's really important. And the second aspect of that is how do you train designers and practitioners to be more friendly with public administration and so they want to go to have them, right? Because usually when you say that if you are a designer and you say you work with public administration, usually people are like, wow, that's weird, right? So that's the point of this axe. And the second one is to build on our community, of course, the French community that we began to develop with La Transfo, and is now quite big, but also the international community with the Mind Lab. For example, we co-organized an event last June with Nicolas and with also some of the people that are here now. So that's another something which is important, to exchange our practice, and so we are not alone in the world and we can be stronger and stuff. The third axis of our new program is about how to imagine the future of administration. Actually, what I will speak in my workshop later on, and I will try to make you think and try to imagine on what subject we can imagine the future of administration, because we have to think ahead, right? We have to think of what we want it to be in 2020, in 2030. And so we have to take space and time to create those, to make it real. And finally, our last axis is about documentation and books. And just as an example, I'm really happy to present you our new Bible, right? It's as big as Piketty, but it's just our last try to really documentate what happened in La Transfo. As I told you, it's a 2 years program, 10 weeks of immersion, so it's really rich in four different regions. So that's why it takes a lot of pages to describe it. But also it's a collective book of 25 persons. We think that writing will really help the movement to be more reflexive, to be more intelligent, to ask the right questions, and also to go further. So to conclude, I will say that now the 27th region is working with basically all the level of administrations in France. We are well known in France as a pioneer of public innovation. We work closely with the Mind Labs and ESTA, but there are so many challenges to face. Now that innovation become like a buzzword and like everybody is taking it for for granted. How can we keep our values and keep the quality of our work as we would like it to be? That's the tricky question now. Thank you.